we approach the darkest days of the year, I think of how fortunate I was to spend a month dancing and traveling in Scandinavia this past summer. In Lapland, the north of Sweden, I watched the sun rise at 3 a.m. after dancing all night. Even when the sun went down, it never got dark, but remained a light dusk. This solar power, along with Sweden's strong, delicious coffee, kept my body recharged. It was a delight to fall into this longer rhythm with the earth and sun, just as it was a delight to fall into the mesmerizing rhythms of the Swedish turning dances and into the haunting melodies of their fiddles. And it goes on to say, as I turn to the dark, I see it now as a balance to the light, a time to rest, to read, to gather together with friends. It is a time to be humbled by darkness, to accept the turning of the earth's northern face away from the sun. So, enjoy as we share with you our way of celebrating the light and the dark. Thank you.
that you'll probably recognize, except this time we've added a few new twists to them.
Thank you.
say?
Thank you. Yeah! great tradition of the Appalachian, tradition of singing, especially solo singing. We don't do a lot of singing because it's hard to dance to singing, but it's been done. And I know lots of people have sung fiddle tunes so that people can dance to them, but in this case, this is just for the pure enjoyment of listening, and I'm going to sing a song that you will find in the Shape Note hymnals, two versions of it, not this version though. This is the version I learned from Lolabelle Reed, and it's such a beautiful, comforting piece. I like to sing it at this time of year, anything that makes us more calm. When I can read my titles clear to mansions in the sky, I'll bid farewell to every fear and worry. My weeping eyes and wipe my weeping eyes and wipe my weeping eyes. I'll bid farewell to my weeping eyes. Should cares like a wild deluge come in storms of troubles fall, by grace I'll safely my God, my God, my heaven, my all, my God, my heaven, my all, my grace safely
Appalachian Mountains, and they brought with them their step dancing and their tunes. And Irish step dancing also is a percussive accompaniment to a tune. And so Amy's going to show us a little bit of Irish dancing tonight. You may notice she's going to do a jig and a reel. You may notice a little bit of a lilting feel in the jig. And you might also notice that she holds her body a little bit different than we do when we do Appalachian clocking. So here's Amy with a little bit of Irish step dancing. Clogging is an African-American tradition of ham boning. And in ham boning, African-American slaves used their bodies to drum after their drums were taken away from them. And so the chest and the legs and the hands and the face are used to create the rhythm. And so here is our version of the African-American traditional tune, ham bone.
Back again. Ham bone, who'd you see?
so from these traditions and many others, the music melded and the dance melded to become what we now know as Appalachian clogging. And our group gets its direct tradition from a group called the Greengrass Cloggers that formed in North Carolina in the 60s. And they kind of took the old traditions and some of the new traditions and blended them together in a performance group. And that's how we got our start. Some of our dances are more modern in their choreography and some of them are more traditional. So in that light, we're going to finish our show with some of our favorite choreographed dances. This is Nine's Company.
Thank you. warm-up. All good dancers know this.
Yeah.
First we better warm him up. All good dancers know this.
Yeah. downstairs.
Hey!
We have a little videotaping of the...
I'm going to tape everything.
Excuse me, we're...
I'll say, here they are, getting dressed.
Actually, this one fits me better. This one fits me better, too.
Tell Laura to
peel. Oh, don't I...
Thank you for coming out tonight. We're very excited to share some old and new dances and tunes. Our group was in Sweden this past summer, and you'll see some glimpses of that in the second half. I'd like to read you something that was written by a fellow clogger, Kristen. As we approach the darkest days of the year, I think of how fortunate I was to spend a month dancing and traveling in Scandinavia this past summer. In Lapland, the north of Sweden, I watched the sun rise at 3 a.m. after dancing all night. Even when the sun went down, it never got dark, but remained a light dusk.
This solar power, along with Sweden's strong, delicious coffee, kept my body recharged. It was a delight to fall into this longer rhythm with the earth and sun, just as it was a delight to fall into the mesmerizing rhythms of the Swedish turning dances and into the haunting melodies of their fiddles. And it goes on to say, as I turn to the dark, I see it now as a balance to the light, a time to rest, to read, to gather together with friends. It is a time to be humbled by darkness, to accept the turning of the earth's northern face away from the sun. So, enjoy as we share with you our way of celebrating the light and the dark. Thank you.
Thank you. state fair big money maker.
Thank you.